Hello and welcome to a special Devil's Advocate with the former Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh on the fifth day of an indefinite fast at Andhra Bhavan, New Delhi. Mr. Naidu, thank you very much for speaking to us. This is the fifth day of your fast. Let me ask you, how are you feeling today?
Little bit weak, but otherwise I'm all right.
Have the doctors been to see you today?
Yeah, morning doctors came to me. One is government doctors, RML. Second is private doctors also.
And what have they told you about your condition? Are you in a position to carry on fasting?
I am confident. Today reports yet to come, but I am confident. Things I can continue.
In which case, let me ask you the most critical question everyone wants to hear you say. Today, are you and your Telugu Desam party in favor of dividing Andhra and creating a new Telangana state?
No, I made it very clear so many times. We have given letter in 2008. Congress party is using always for political gain. That is not good for the society.
I'll come to the Congress party in a moment's time. Let me first concentrate on your party.
What I am saying, today you wanted to do divide, you have to do equal justice for both the regions.
Okay. There are two parts to your answer. Let's take them one by one. To begin with, in October 2008, the Politburo of your party, its highest decision-making body, passed a resolution in favor of Telangana. On the 18th of October 2008, you wrote to Pranab Mukherjee saying you support Telangana. On the 27th of December 2012, you wrote to Sushil Kumar Shinde saying you stand by the 2008 decision. So my first question is, today, in October 2013, do you stand by the 2008 decision to create Telangana?
All these decisions, my Politburo resolution, from the beginning I am saying continuously, same resolution I am accepting.
So
in that resolution, I made it very clear, justice to be done, everybody.
I'll come to the second half in a moment's time. But you're saying to me categorically, you stand by the 2008 resolution.
Yes, but in that, it is very clear, equal justice.
I'll come to the but in a moment, but I first want to clarify.
Yeah.
You stand by the 2008 resolution?
Yes.
You are in favor of creating Telangana?
Yes.
Yes.
That is what I'm saying. Before that, you have to sort it out on the same Andhra problems.
I'll come to the second half later. Just so clarify the first half.
It is interlinked. That is what I'm saying. Without doing injustice, you cannot go further.
All right, in which case, I'll come to the second half. You're making it clear that your support for Telangana depends upon how the government handles the anger of the Simandhra people.
Yes, yes, I am very clear on that.
Why are you linking the two together?
No, what I am saying, I am asking one question. How many children you have?
I have no children.
Your father?
My father had four.
Four. If you ask our father, if you can select any one of you, he will show equal love and affection to all children.
In which case, let me put this conclusion to you. Your support for Telangana is not a support of principle, it is conditional support.
100%, always. But I am saying not conditional. Any partition, any division in a family in India, even your family or before your elders, there are elderly people to settle the issue.
Mr. Naidu, the people of Telangana are hearing you. The people of Simandhra are hearing you.
Yeah,
the message going to Telangana is that your support for Telangana is conditional.
No, not conditional. Absolute. It is what I am saying. It is justice. Without doing justice, you cannot hit one part of Andhra Pradesh. They are all Telugu community.
In other words,
you cannot divide them.
In other words, you are saying you will not support Telangana if what you consider justice for Simandhra does not happen.
Yes, 100%. I am for Telugu people.
Let me put it like this. There are many people who say that there is no amicable way of creating Telangana. No matter when you create it, no matter how you create it, you will annoy the people of Simandhra. You cannot do equal justice to both.
What I am saying, there is possible. Government of India, what they are doing, they want to take political advantage. That is, first of all, it is totally wrong. It is a very bad game they are playing.
What do you consider justice for Simandhra today? Given that you have a resolution in favor of Telangana and you stand by it, but you say you want justice for Simandhra, that is the condition.
Yeah.
What then, in your eyes, constitutes justice for Simandhra?
There is water problem, there is education problem, education issues problem, there are employment opportunities. They are all worried about Hyderabad.
Is Hyderabad also a problem?
Yeah, they are all worried about Hyderabad also. And also, if you can go through revenue sharing, all these things they have to do.
You've listed four or five things.
Yeah.
Water, natural resources, yeah. Revenue sharing, yeah. Hyderabad.
Yeah.
The
employment opportunities.
Employment as well. The fifth.
Revenue share.
The government has appointed a group of ministers to go into those specific problems. Why is that not, in your eyes, a sufficient step?
What I'm saying, judgment is given. Now they are asking, you argue. Is it correct? It is a, whenever I am asking you one question, partition or division, whenever it is inevitable, even common men in the village, they will apply common knowledge. First of all, they will ask them to sit together. They will sort out differences. Then they will go for division.
I want to pick
they
up
will
on
do
what you're
equal
saying.
Distance.
Are you therefore saying that the first step the government must take is to bring all the parties together?
No, but not only Andhra parties. You divided the parties now. One side, TRS and Congress, you are having match fixing.
If you say not only Andhra parties, what other parties should be involved?
What I am saying, you are outgoing government. That's very clear. Within 6 months, you will go anyway.
Well, we don't know for sure. Let's not jump to that conclusion.
That is what I am saying. That is our opinion. Coming government, can they accept your proposal?
Just a moment. Come back to the justice you want. You've named five areas where you think justice is needed for the Simandhra people. What steps do you want the government to take? They've appointed a GOM. You think that's not sufficient?
What I am saying, there is no even single gentleman from Andhra Pradesh. There is no leaders from Andhra Pradesh. Who are
so
all
the
deciding?
The first thing the GOM should have is leaders from Andhra Pradesh as members.
Not only that, I am not talking GOM is only a tomorrow they will finalize. It is only they wanted to endorse government opinion.
So be specific. What steps should they take in terms of Hyderabad, revenue sharing, water, employment? What steps should they take?
What I am saying, affected people, there are JACs, stakeholders, and also some other forums. I met president. I met opposition leaders. What I said, both areas you call them, discuss with them, solve the problem amicably.
But first of all, there have been all party meetings already held on this issue. How will one more help?
What I am saying, in Simandhra, political parties have become irrelevant.
So then who should be involved in the discussion?
There are JACs. There are, what I am saying, because of...
You mean invite the joint action committees?
Before that, I will tell you one thing. What is democracy? Democracy means political parties enter, they will represent the people, they will fight for government.
I understand what you're saying. I get the feeling that you don't have specific points in mind. All
you want is people to sit down together. You are thoroughly mistaken. There are precedents. There is a constitutional provisions. You cannot bypass everything. It is not a Congress internal affair.
But at the moment, the government is not bypassing constitutional provisions.
This is only a high-handed way they have done for political gain. That is what I am saying. They cannot do political gain, first of all. What they have done, 100 years Congress party was there in Simandhra. Now all party leaders are revolting against them. They burnt their party. They are supporting Jagan Mohan Reddy. What is this?
You may be right that they are doing it for political gain, but the truth is, and you know this, that all parties act for political gain. The opposition acts for gain, the government acts for gain. So let me come back.
Always you should not act on political gain on important issues and on sensitive issues.
Is there not a sense in which Chandra Babu Naidu today is also acting on political gain?
No.
Are you not putting
I am very clear. I am acting in the interest of Telugu community. You cannot divide community for our political gain.
Let me put it like this. You are today on the fifth day of your fast.
Yeah.
You told me you've lost 4 kilos, but you're determined to continue.
Yeah.
What is it that the government must do so that you stop your fast? Put it like that.
No, I don't want to ask them. I came here to expose government of India and the Congress party and also tell to the nation justice has to be done.
But what is the purpose of this fast? What are you wanting to achieve?
I want to tell the nation and also opposition parties and also media. Through media I want to tell the nation how treacherous game Congress has done.
So your fast is a vehicle or a means of drawing attention to the problem.
That's what I'm saying. Again, justice to be done.
So your fast is a quest for justice.
Yes.
What constitutes justice?
What I'm saying, any common man will understand what is justice. Equal justice for both the regions. That is what I'm asking.
But today you're on your fourth day or fifth day, you're getting weaker. How long will you continue?
I don't mind my life or health. People are suffering. They are having a fear of their future for their children.
When you say you are on an indefinite fast, what does the word indefinite mean?
I can do as long as I can do, God permits.
As long as I can do, you mean you are determined to continue till you die?
No, it is only a matter of time. But I am very clear. Justice has to be done.
But that's the question. If you are on a fast for justice, you have to define justice in concrete terms. Otherwise, the government doesn't know what to do.
No, but I'm saying government, they are willingly, wantonly, they are doing all these things. Even they have constituted one cabinet MOUs committee. Again, they have changed. Now they are going something. Every day they are giving inconsistent statements.
Do you want the government to postpone and delay the creation of Telangana? If they make that announcement, is that something you would consider justice?
I'm not saying that. They have to discuss with both the areas, do equal justice. It is only outgoing government. You involve national parties also.
You want a discussion with JACs and the national parties?
Yes, both the areas.
What is the role of a party like the Bahujan Samaj Party or the Samajwadi Party or the Trinamool Conference? How do they get involved?
No, what I am saying, they are also have some ideas. You know, they are representing politics in the country.
So you want everyone in the country to get together?
Not everyone, as far as possible. You select some parties who are all important.
Let me put this to you. People listening to you will say that this is not justice. This is a way of deliberately delaying the process. And he doesn't have a good explanation, so all he's saying is put everyone together to talk about it.
What I'm saying, you are blaming me, national media is blaming me, and also Congress party is blaming me. But you go to Simandra, for the last 72-73 days, NGOs are on strike. People came voluntarily. They are afraid of their future for their children. You have to assure them.
Let me put one thing to you. The government has reconstituted the group of ministers. It's been reduced from 10 to 7. The earlier group had a deadline of 6 weeks. The new group has no deadline. Do you believe that the government is through this way trying to find time, trying to delay and postpone the process? No. And is that a first step in your eyes?
No, I am not. What is the conspiracy they are having? We don't know. They will prepone or postpone. We don't know. What I am saying, can you hear me 1 minute? I will ask. So many partitions has been happened in India. From Chennai, Tamil Nadu, Andhra was separated. At that time, there were gentlemen, leaders, they stood together.
Koti Sri Ramallu had to fast to death to achieve Andhra. Today is Chandrababu Naidu. Prepared to fast unto death for what he calls justice. Are you prepared to go that far?
No, what I am saying, Gandhiji has done so many times on indefinite fast. What it indicates for truth, for justice,
are you prepared to go all the way to death?
What I am saying, as long as God permits, I will do it.
But this is not in God's hands, this is in your hands.
What I am saying, you
have to
understand.
It's you who's fasting. And that's why I'm asking you, are you prepared to go all the way to death?
I wanted to fight it out to the last for justice for Andhra.
Last means till you die.
No.
You are really prepared to go that far?
What I'm saying, people are pressurizing me as on today. Your health is important, all these things. But I am considering beyond my health, public interest is important.
My problem is this. You have taken up a cause that you consider noble, I don't quarrel with that. You have gone on an indefinite fast till you achieve your goal. The problem is that your goal is not clearly defined. You want justice, and all that justice seems to be is everyone must sit and talk. Is that all you want? A meeting of people to sit and talk and nothing more?
No, and ultimately you have to find amicable solution.
But how can you ever persuade the people of Simandhra that Telangana has to be made a separate state? That's the problem. It can never be something that they will like and accept.
No, what I am saying, I have discussed all these things. Now, whenever you want to hit them for our political gain, they will react automatically. There is a hidden agenda. People are aware.
But the point I'm making is this. Is there any way that the separation of Telangana from the rest of Andhra can be made acceptable to Rayalaseema and coastal Andhra? They will always hate it. No matter how much you talk about it, it will be unacceptable. So the proposal you have of sit down and talk is simply a delaying tactic.
What I'm saying, what you have done, for a political reason you have decided. And at the same time you are having a match fixing. People are aware that both TRS and also
SR. All of that is true.
I'm telling you.
All of that is true.
No, I'm telling you one more thing. People are thinking their future is very bleak. Why are they thinking their children's future is totally very.
You see, you're saying
there won't be any
future.
You're
saying what I'm saying. I am prepared to accept your allegation that Congress is doing this for political gain. All parties do things for gain. The problem is not Congress. Your problem is anguish of the people in Simandhra. How can you allay that? How can you remove that without saying, I reverse Telangana? The second you do Telangana, they will be upset. There is no way you can make Telangana acceptable to Simandhra. You're looking for the impossible.
No, in democracy, what I am saying, always discussions, deliberations, consultations.
But doesn't a full stop come to discussions at some point? You can't keep discussing forever.
You can do amicable solution, mutual agreed solution.
What is the amicable solution? Can you think of it?
You go on discussing, you will emerge. What I am saying all these days.
This is a futile hope. Keep discussing it.
No, what I am saying, that is the mistake you are doing. Ultimately, in democracy, discussions are important. After this incident, I am telling you, I called editors. I called electronic media senior journalist in Andhra Pradesh, and also analyst, and also intellectuals. I discussed for an amicable solution.
But did you find an amicable solution? That's the point.
What I'm saying, if you call on discussing and tell them what is truth, how to do it, then you will get amicable solution.
Listen,
If I am in that chair, I will decide within 1 year amicable solution. That is what I challenged.
Mr. Naidu, let's take a break at that point. When I come back, I want to suggest that perhaps you're approaching this the wrong way around. That's in a moment's time. See you after the break. Welcome back to Devil's Advocate and an exclusive interview with Chandrababu Naidu on the fifth day of an indefinite fast when he's clearly looking weak and suffering. Mr. Naidu, I want to come back to the man sitting in front of me who is on a fast, indefinite, as he says, to the last. That could mean you could be fasting to death. Are you worried about your own future? You may have boxed yourself into a corner.
No, I am not worried about my future. I am worried about my Telugu community future. Telugu Desam Party formed only to protect Telugu people.
I understand.
No, I have to do justice for that. Nobody can take it granted.
But Mr. Naidu, if you want to do justice, you need to live and fight, not die.
I will fight it out. I will fight it out. As long as I can do, I can do it.
But how will you fight it out if every day on this fast you are getting weaker, you are endangering your health, and if you are serious in saying you are prepared to go to the last, you could end up like Poti Sri Raramallu. Do you really believe that you will help the Telugu people by becoming a martyr?
So what I am saying here, this is a very important issue. As long as I can do, I can do. I am not going to leave this fight.
But these people, and there may be 100 or 200, 300, maybe 1,000, they want you to live. They don't want you to die. I put it to you, it may be wiser in their interest and in the interest of Telugu people that you give up this fight and fight politically, not in this way.
As long as my health and also God permit, I will fight. After this also, I'm not going to
My leave. Last question, it's not as long as God permits. You are on a hunger strike. It is as long as you want to continue. Will you really endanger
no,
your
my,
life?
My health condition is telling to me, you continue.
Till when?
Let us see. As long I am a strong built person. Last time also I had done 9 days for farmers issue. I will continue.
I wish you the best of luck. Thank you very much for
Thank
speaking
you.
To me
Thank
on a
you.
Day when you're clearly not feeling well.
Thank you.